Hey guys, Shannions here, and I'm back playing Firewatch. And we were, like, just assaulted after we found a clipboard that had recorded conversations between Delilah and myself. And, we found a radio, and then we got hit in the head, and then we woke up, and we're gonna go to Wapiti, or, well, I call it Wapiti, but apparently the correct pronunciation is Wapiti. Wapiti Station up north. But there's a locked gate, so we're gonna go down to the scout camp that's been looking out on the fire, the flapjack fire that is happening around these parts. So stuff is going down for sure. I went down. I got smacked down hardcore, and my theory is it's Mitch or Flashlight Man or both, because Mitch is Flashlight Man, who took the girls to his alien government bunker in Wapiti Station. This look the same? Was this stream here, like, many, many days ago? I don't remember it starting so far back.
Maybe I called it did. Around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No, nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
Delilah.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
It's nothing, I promise.
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay. Keep your radio close to you.
Okay.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
Yeah.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Yeah.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No, I'm not. Okay, let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Don't like it. Don't like it at all. I did want to check out up here. You see below Hawk's Rest, there's a little area to the south of it that I don't know if it was blocked off before or what. Let's check it out. Okay. Cause, yeah. If I can find any clues as to what the flip is going on, that would be great. Or should I wait until I've got, whatever I need to cut down bushes. Maybe I'll do that. Okay, we're gonna go back home. I'm gonna go through the cave. It will be fine. I'm not going to get attacked again. This is great. Do I still have a flashlight? Hello? Anybody in here? That tree here last time? Don't know. Yeah. We need to get in that cave. Okay. We survived the cave. This is where we ran into Flashlight Man last time.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling.
Well, me neither.
I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It
yeah.
just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
He had his dad to protect him. Ned, right?
Yeah.
You don't think he could?
No, you're probably right.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
She doesn't sound too confident. I don't think she's sure that they got out of here. I'm not confident they got out of here. I'm not confident I'll get out of here. Oh, man. What if I don't get out of here? I've got to see Julia again, right? I mean, she's my wifey baby boo-boo-chan. So... yeah. Also, Delilah's out here. I can't let anything bad happen to her. She's pretty cool. Alright, we're almost back. And, then we can go maybe run into other people for once that we can actually interact with face to face. That might be fun, right? As long as they aren't crazies. What if this person out here killed the fire people? What about that? Anything creepy in my outhouse? Just my baseball. Okay. Oh, this tree fell over. Oh, poor baby. Let's check on Bucket Jr. before we head out. Maybe we can also read our last book up here. And for a second I was like, what if we run into someone who's in our place while we're supposed to be away? But it's looks pretty safe. Do you want something in there? Can I get you something? You want some jam? Maybe some peanut butter? Here, how about Julia? Julia can keep you company. Oh, Julia, get in the bucket. I mean, the bin. There you go. There you go, bucket. Ooh, is this new? July 15th, 1989. There was a meteor shower last night, and man, if you've never seen 100 miles from a streetlight during one... Wait, what? There was a meteor shower last night, and man... if you've never been 100 miles from a streetlight during one, you're really missing out. Oh, I see what he's saying. Cause, light pollution. Gotcha. Alright. I sat outside with my feet on the railing and watched them zoom overhead until 3 in the morning. Even with the fire still burning, they were the brightest shooting stars I'd ever seen. Dee hung in till past midnight, and we had a good time watching them together. I've been thinking a lot about life after working out here. One thing is for sure, I want to come back next year. Would be great if Dee was back in Thoroughfare and I got to do 2 forks again. Dee was saying that the Forest Service likes to keep people in the same lookouts. You get better at the job that way, I guess. So maybe I'll leave my typewriter out here over the winter so I don't have to hike out with it on my back. After the season, I was thinking I'd see if there was more NFS work out there, or call up Dixon at Cotton Mountain and see about working at the slopes. Would be nice to get back into skiing, and honestly, after a couple months of being outside, I'm not sure I'm ready to be stuck indoors. We'll see. Oh, so he's really liking it, despite all the creepy stuff. I totally missed that! I don't have my wedding ring on anymore. What? Henry. I mean, if that's your decision, I'll let you keep it off. That's fine. Let's see. Okay, right. The halfling village in the orc pond. That's where we're headed. Let's do it. Oh! Oh!
Yeah, that fantasy map from before looks like it was made by Brian Goodwin. The handwriting matches everything in that folder I found.
Maybe it just fell out a while back?
I guess.
We'll just cover that ring. Super duper. Okay, any new surprises? Any other new surprises? Other than jam and pasta sauce? Jeez, almost missed that stuff. Okay, let's see. The Patriots by Donald Anderson. Can't remember if I brought this one or not. It begins and ends deep in Red Russia, where they sent him to spy, where they urged him to kill, and where they learned that he wasn't the Patriot they had hoped. Sent to plant the poison pill of espionage inside the dinner of the communist bear Ray Friedman. Oh, wait, no. The bear, the communist bear isn't Ray, but Ray is the Patriot? Ray Friedman would return to his government's doorstep disgraced and disowned by his keepers, forced back into civilian life as a simple comptroller, but with the intelligence and super skills bestowed upon him by the United States government, Ray struggles to fade into obscurity. That is, until a janitor named Claude L. Williams reveals that he, too, was there the night in Stalingrad, the night everything went wrong, and the truth was made clear. Can two men ever return to civilian life in possession of information that will destroy both themselves and a presidency? Will the government even let them? I want to think like the books tie into stuff somehow. Oh, flapjack fire.
Whoa, the flapjack fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Okay. I don't know how forest fires work, other than you're not supposed to start them. That's about all I know about them. You know. What was that bear? Forest fire bear. Only you can prevent forest fires. Now I am a forest fire preventer. Well, I'm more of a forest fire spotter. I get paid to be like, hey, that's a fire. Hello. Trail sign that is knocked down. Hold on, any other suspicious stuff? Ooh, there's a trail. Ooh, where does that go? Ooh. Okay, let's examine the sign and we'll check that out. Hold on. Checking around. It's just go around the two forks. Have I ever even been over here? Where am I? Okay, this goes to the medicine wheel. Okay, back road to the medicine wheel. All right. Okay. Alright, I'm just looking around, making sure nothing sketchy's going on, you know. Making sure everything's on the up and up. Okay, I just went in a circle. Clever girl. Okay, let's check out this sign that is taken down. Where am I going? This way, okay. Hey, fire. Nice to see you, except not. Here we go. Examine. Yes, good. Replace. There we go. Where should I? It's supposed to be facing that way? Oh, whatever. Hope that doesn't come back to bite me in the bum bum. It would be a no good bonito. Alright, we have to remember to explore that other path that's on the north side of the river. Remember. Hey, River, I'm back. I am so glad to see you. You are gorgeous. Am I supposed to go this way? Hold on. Oh, so talented. Oh, this is great. This is fantastic. Who needs to get your feet wet when you can jump? Oh, so talented. Oh, yes. Just the best. Lending library, there's new stuff in it. Oh my gosh. Don't freak out. Terminal 7 by Richard Sturgeon, now a major motion picture starring Anders Nelson. What? Wow. Wow. Neil Black got casted. And Richard Sturgeon's cashing in. Alright, go Richard. Thanksgiving. South City Airport is packed to the gills with travelers eager to ditch the dreary metropolis for the holiday. And a group of Soviet terrorists has just ensured that nobody is going anywhere. Bleh, former South City cop turned world-class detective Neil Black can cut through the red tape. Bleh, give the hostages a fighting chance while the FBI bleh to start World War III. Black knows the only person who could have orchestrated this act of terror. And it's not Ivan. Starring Michael Keaton with Kurt Russell as Don Carl, Terminal 7 comes to the big screen summer of 1986. Sweet deal. Ugh, man. Just have no coordination. And The Accidental Savior by Terrence L. Greenbrier. November 21st, 1963. John Russell knows that the president's life hangs in the balance, but who would believe him? Not just another James Bond. That's good. Oh, it was on sale, 65 cents. Steal. All right. Should have brought a book so we could take one with us. Recent burn?
I found where they did the control.
Oh, wow. What?
Normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to two forks.
Ooh.
Now that there's someone in it.
Yeah.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Yeah.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river.
Okay.
There should be a pond on the way.
Got it.
Okay.
What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
What about dead? They don't get dead, do they?
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
I didn't get it, but then I got it. He thought she was fired because it's a fire. This place is pretty. Oh my gosh. Look how green these trees are. Okay, let's figure out what we're doing here. Oh, fire break. Okay. Should we get the cachet? Let's do that. Leaves, you are so distracting. Okay. Let's hang a right. Check out this place. Okay. Any secrets around here? Any turtles need a rescuing? Maybe a squirrel or a baby chipmunk? I love a baby chipmunk. I mean, I wouldn't want them to be abandoned by their mother, but I would care for it like it was my own. Hello? Big tree. Big imposing tree. That could be on the cover of a book. What is this? What is a ski doing here? It's actually called Big Tree. Why is there? I don't understand. Should I take a photo? It's weird, isn't it? Let's take a photo. That was not the right thing to do. There we go. Okay. Took a photo of a weird ski. Singular ski. Where is the cache? Where you at, girl? Ooh, it's on a little island. Okay. Let's check her everywhere. I see you, cache. I'll get to you in a minute. In a minute. Hello, damn. Let's go down the other shoreline. This one that I'm on right now. Let's check that out. Or, I don't know. Anything the fire left behind? Or something somebody left behind after the fire? Hello. Hello. Let's go to the medicine wheel. Ooh, okay, all right. I see it, I see it. Mm-hmm. Everything's connected. Oh, man. I know the game. The game's like, you're not gonna see anyone else out here, right? So I doubt I'm gonna find these fire working people, these fire tamers. Crazy fire tamers. I'm curious if I'll ever see Delilah. So many questions. I'm starting to be like, is she in a wheelchair or something? But that wouldn't make any sense for her to be a fire watchman and be all the way out here if she was in a wheelchair, right? That'd just be like ridiculous. Right? Show me your secrets, Cache. Show them to me. Okay. Don't. I'm afraid while I'm in this, I'm gonna get attacked. I don't like being attacked. Once was enough attacking. This one was in backwards. That is 4, 3, 2, 1. Don't you rustle your bushes at me. Just one stray match. Protect the forest. Let's see. Okay, yeah, we found that path through to the medicine wheel. This map is really dirty. That's about all there is on here. Okay, 3 blind rats and some old canned food. Let's see. Reading a lot of books today. It's just one of those days. Oh, the cover was ripped. It's not nice. Let's see. When FBI informants need protection, you call the police. When those informants wind up dead, you call Neo Black. In a rain-soaked return to South City, Neo Black is hung out to dry as the only man who can piece an FBI case back together with danger lurking around every corner. Introducing Black's Blair, the shadowy Don Carl, three blind mice is Sturgeon at his best. Neo Black is stabbed in the back. Who will be the one holding the carving knife? One thing's for sure, it's not the farmer's wife. I don't get it. Is that supposed to be funny? What farmer's wife? He works in the city. I don't know. If the bushes could stop rustling, that would be just really appreciated. Just super appreciated. That tree and that ski are wigging me out. Just wigging me out. All right. Let's do it. Let's find us an axe, probably, or something else that is cutty and can take down a locked gate, because locked gates are bad news bears. I don't know. All I know is I want to get into Wapiti or Wapiti, that place. I wish to go to there. What is that? Back where I started. Okay. There's a stuff here. The signpost is missing again.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah, where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Oh, okay.
Because it's called Pork Pond.
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den. Or, you know, anywhere.
Uh-huh.
So, is the scout camp anywhere near Pork Pond?
Yeah, it is. Just keep heading east. You'll cross a small ravine and you shouldn't be able to miss it.
What's with the snow gear out here? And the skis? I guess in winter it gets pretty snowy out here?
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
It looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across old Pork Pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
If he ever got back, maybe it's Mitch.
Whoa.
Wait, no, he went missing in July.
Stripped these snowmobiles down to the bone.
Huh.
I mean, that's weird, right?
Yes.
I mean, I can come up with a bunch of not weird reasons someone would do that out here, but given what's happened, yeah. Yeah, that's weird.
Yeah, it's weird, Flashlight Man. Living out here? You're gonna steal my generator next? You like stealing stuff? Ooh, Pondy. Oh, did they do it to this engine too? Looks like it. Okay, this isn't creepy at all. Hope these fire dudes are okay. But they're probably not. They're probably not even there. Camp Arapaho. Am I going the right way? Yeah. Right. Okay, yeah. 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 Let's check around here first. Maybe get a look at what we're gonna be dealing with. Oh, long drop. Okay. I'll pass on the long drop in the moment. Ooh. We can cut down that tree later. Maybe, possibly. Or an easier way to get around. Hello. Oh, another tree. So many trees to cut down. If only we had, like, something to cut them with and stuff. You know, like something sharp that could also take out a locked gate. That'd be great. Fantastic, even. Okay, I don't see any turtles. So we will continue with our main mission. Get something sharp and wieldy. Definitely wieldy.
Camp Arapaho.
You're there?
Yeah, I
am. Yeah.
It's been out there since the 50s.
I was never really into the idea of the scouts.
No.
There's something about men organizing boys around their ideals. Never sat right with me.
Wear weebelows in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers.
Mm.
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Oh, yeah, I know where that is. It's right over here. I got your high ground. Right here. Alley-oop. Should we report it? Uh-oh. I want to have the dialogue. No. Okay, well, we tried. An attempt was made. Okay, there's the entrance. Okay. Let's do it. Hello? Hello? Any secrets? Ooh, it's the camp. Oh, it doesn't look good. Doesn't look good. Oh, it looks okay-ish.
You ever talked to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
What type of nerdy hobbies are we talking about with him? Like, a marching band?
Oh, no. Like comics, model rockets, wizards and wyverns, you know.
Ugh.
Hey, thanks to Brian, I can almost recall by memory the armor classes of most dragons.
Ooh.
What? No, you can't.
Hey, planar dragons armor class. Let's see.
Okay, no, I believe you. We're good.
I was interested. Jeez.
I guess these little shelters are where they keep the Weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
Okay. Bear trap.
There are bear traps out here, in the scout shelters.
Scouts are stalwart prey.
That's messed up.
It is messed up. We already have one of these, don't we? Should we take it? Taking it. Okay. Bear trap in a scout shelter. That's a little bit odd. Let's see what else we got. Okay, kind of a symbol there. Obviously not interesting enough. Okay. Where am I going? I'm in the scout camp. Is it past the scout camp? Okay, just looking out for dead little boy bodies. Because who knows? There's my friend. My axe.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
Pulaski?
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
For both getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Mm-hmm. Taking it. Yes. Pulaski acquired. What's up through here? Where am I going? Back up above the camp? Oh, okay. All right. I'm in a maze of my own mind. See some papers here. A memo.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
We'll see.
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
Yeah.
My mother always said I would meet someone who'd give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Okay.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching?
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
Yeah.
I do. Yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I don't think that's it.
Allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but God, if you saw what you said you did, fuck, Henry.
Quick.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
You don't have to tell me twice. Alright, let's read this. Squad boss Grant Carson of the Wyoming Interagency Hotshot Crew. From Wyoming. Let's see. Dr. Simmons at WPD Station Thoroughfare Region. Squad boss Carson, in the next few days, you and your team will be dropping into the Thoroughfare Region of the Shoshone National Forest to cut a fire line south of Ruby River. I'm writing you on behalf of Dr. Ben Simmons at Wapiti Station. He reached out to the superintendent with wildfire concerns about his research site. Upon your return, someone from his office will want to speak with you as part of a wildfire risk assessment of the region. I told them they have nothing to worry about and that your team's fire lines are the most potent preventative measure in protecting their site, even though they'll be more than a mile away, but I think they've got insurance companies to answer to. Thanks as always for your service, Rich Slusarenko, Assistant Superintendent. So they called the fire folks because he was worried about his research station. Oh, I could finally cut through this junk. Get the flip out of here. Okay, alright, sure. Okay, alright. Fantastic, marvelous. Beautiful. Alright, let's cut down these trees. Cut you down, girl. I'm gonna cut you down. It's your time to go. Alright. Did it. Good job. Okay. Aw, such a cute little hop. Little hoppity hop. Okay. Well, we've got an axe now, so there's lots of stuff we can check out. Okay. Well. So much stuff to check out, actually. We'll get to it. Don't you worry. I'm an experienced hiker who now has a Polanski. I got an axe, so we can handle ourselves, and watch out anybody tries to sneak up and punch me in the back of the head. Because I'm armed. You better watch out. Until next time, thanks for watching. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.